Hey everybody, Lego Jang here with a final look at the Hero Factory Breakout Wave 2 Hero sets. This is not going to be a review. I've already done individual reviews of each of these sets, including showing speed builds of each and showing the parts before they're put together. So if you want details about each one, you'll have to look at my specific reviews for each of these sets. This is just a general overview, like I always do at the end, after completing all of my individual reviews. So, what do we have here? The most conspicuous thing about this series here, or at least this wave of this series, is that, well, there are only four sets this time. Seems like each time we're getting fewer and fewer sets. That's if you don't count Breeze, because Breeze technically was released in the United States with Wave 2, but she was already released overseas in Wave 1 quite some months ago. So that's up to you to determine how you want to count that. But with the new ones, the actual new ones, it's just four. So it's kind of interesting what's going on with that. I really don't feel a major loss for some reason with it going down to just four. I think going from six to five was a little bit more jarring to me, just because of the history of always having six heroes in the Bionicle series that preceded Hero Factory. Now we've got, now we're down to four, but when we moved down to five, it was just a little bit upsetting to me to be missing one. But they've added in some newer building techniques and some newer pieces here. Really, personally, not that sad to only have four. I think there are four pretty decent ones, and we've also got four pretty decent and varied villain sets also that I'll be doing a separate video to cover all of those. We do have a Titan this time, or a extra large, an XL version of a hero this time. He is built much more simply, Stormer XL, built much more simply than the last XL that we had, who was Rocka XL. I am very, very happy that the big guy that they chose to put in this series is not a rookie. Doesn't make sense to me for a brand new character to get the largest set in the series, unless it's a combination of a small character plus a really nice vehicle to go with it. So Stormer coming back in huge form now, the original Alpha Team leader, he deserves it. I'm happy for Stormer the character, and glad that they brought him back in. Like I said, it is much simpler than the last XL. They've really reduced the parts count by using a lot of these friction adder joints. So they've put them at every single joint on the legs, which allows them to get away with having a larger, heavier character that stands up on his own without needing extra double joints and all that kind of stuff. And it works out just fine, I think. And if anything, might even fit in a little bit better with the thought of him just being a larger, regular hero and not being in some sort of mech suit or anything like that. Ends up just being a very tall and broad looking character, a little bit awkward, but I think he works out okay. And all throughout all the characters, each and every one of them still has the blaster. That's something that seems to be a requirement internally within LEGO, that with each of the Breakout series characters that they have a weapon that can actually shoot. And I think that with the focus that Hero Factory has on being for younger kids, I think that's really important, because the younger the user is, the more likely they are to really have imaginative play, actual active play with the set. So it's good to have something that actually does something, that actually moves on its own. Stringer was another one that was a little bit odd to see in this series, because he has completely changed his color scheme. That said, though, having a completely changed color scheme, I think it is a good one. I'm gonna miss the old lots of black with a little bit of orange, but looks like Bulk is picking up more of the orange now, and it's all right. I think Stringer's a pretty cool character as a character, and as a set, I'm really glad to have the the translucent blue with them. The guitar style of Blaster is kind of cool too. And that's pretty much it for the stuff that's really different this time around. We get to see Nex for the very first time with what would have been his 1.0 series helmet, which is just derived aesthetically from the 2.0 version, where he had the visor and skull cap piece separately. Otherwise, this is a pretty standard character, with, again, going back to having just one hand on this character, the other side is just direct connected here. And then finally, Bulk, again, one hand on this side. I know a lot of folks don't appreciate that. Thankfully, Stormer actually did get two hands, and also Stringer does have two hands, but Bulk has just the one, just like he did originally. And here again, I'm happy to see a character kind of looking fairly appropriate. You know, he is called Bulk, and he was given a lot of Bulk to him, to the set itself. And a pretty respectable looking figure. The only thing that I didn't really appreciate was the way this missile launcher works back here, which it just doesn't work very well, because the articulation, it can move like so, but that's about it. You can turn up and down, but it can't turn really across his body, and it's very limiting. And when you look at it from the side, it's kind of centered way back from the back of him. So on the whole, not necessarily the best series that they've had. A little bit of randomness with this one, with the looks. It's not all completely cohesive of just looking like one series. They've gone in some different directions a little bit, but not too bad. I appreciate the new parts for mock making. There are plenty of them. You can see those in more detail in the individual reviews. And I'm happy with the series. I think that I was a little bit happier with Breakout Wave 1, just remembering back to how I felt at that time. But I think some of that may have been just based on my like for the theme, the Breakout theme on the whole. And I continue to really like the Breakout theme. I think that it's brilliant. I think it's great to keep the old characters in play, or to bring them back, which makes it so that, you know, all the kids who have the older sets can bring them out and really feel like they're being part of the current story, even with their older sets. So that's really important, and I'm happy that that continues, and I hope that it will continue for at least one more series. But we'll have to see how that works out. That's about it for now. I am done with these. I've also done the combination models between them and the villains that they are set to fight against officially. So all those videos are up. You can find them on my channel, youtube.com/LEGOJANG. And I will continue to review new sets as they come out in the future. But for right now, after finishing up these overview videos, it will be time to go back to making my own creations, custom mocks. So I look forward to that very much. Thanks a lot for watching. I'll talk to you again soon.